Good evening.
So exciting to have so much activity in church and so much joy. We welcome you to Assumption. I'm Anne Marie Kwan. I'm the Director of Religious Education. The students and the teachers are very excited to share with you what they've been working on for the past few weeks. If you haven't already done so, please take a moment to turn your cell phones off. At the end of the performance, your child will wait for you where he or she is, whether it's on the steps or in a pew. I will come up and then direct you how to pick up your children. So if everybody at the end would just stay put, that would be perfect. And now I'd like to welcome our pastor, Father Nick, to begin our evening with a prayer.
I assume that's for Anne-Marie. Let's begin. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mighty Father, we thank you for this opportunity. We're able to experience the true joy and delight of our children, the great gift that they are to all of us. We pray that their joy may be contagious to us, may be assigned to us of the true Christmas spirit, that we be open to all the gifts you offer us in our life. We are reminded of the true gift of Jesus Christ as a child born amongst us. We pray that they be inspired by this evening, as recognizing the joy they are to bring to others, the joy they are to experience themselves, that they continue to grow in their love and their understanding that you love them. We ask your blessings upon all of us. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you and welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Came in the country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord surrounded them, and they were afraid. The angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you great tidings of joy for all the people to hear. For unto you born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Jesus Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. There's a couple gardeners up for grabs. And now it's the pre-K parents. Your children are seated over this direction. If you would go over and safely locate your child. Thank you, everybody. Have a Merry Christmas.
let's read. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome. It's so nice to see our church packed full so that you can share in the hard work that these kids have been doing for several weeks. I'm Anne Marie Kwan. I'd like to welcome you to Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. The students and teachers are so excited to share with you what they've been doing. If you have not already done so, would you please turn off or silence your cell phones? At the end of the night, when they finish, I'm going to ask all parents and audience to stay seated, and then we will call you by grade level to come get your child, because the kids will be in different spots all over the church so that no child gets lost or scared. Just stay put, and then we'll call you by grade level. Now I'd like to welcome Father Nick, who is going to start our night off with a prayer.
He's taking my stage. Let's begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mighty Father, we thank you for this opportunity. As we continue throughout this Advent season to prepare ourselves for Christmas, we are open to all the blessings you give us in our life. We see in our children, in their continued growth, the blessings that they have, the way in which they cooperate with it. As we've seen through the younger children earlier, as we see through these children as they grow through the years, we pray that we always be open to cooperate with your blessings in our life. We thank you for our teachers. We thank you for all who are helping to raise our children. We ask that they may understand your love in their life and see it throughout our community. We ask your blessings upon all of us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Get together for this Christmas movie night. It's going to be so much fun.
Yeah!
We all look so cute at Christmas gifts. Let's get a selfie.
Now let's get the hot chocolate poured.
I'll take whipped cream and marshmallows and mine.
Don't forget to pass around the Christmas cookies.
Oh, yum, gingerbread cookies.
I decorated this one to look like Dr. Hensley.
Which movie should we watch first?
Let's just turn on the TV and flip through to see what's on.
Oh, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
I loved watching it whenever I was a kid.
Yes, but Harvey the Elf, who didn't want to make toys. He wanted to be a dentist.
Oh, that's right. In the past, I was in the whole line of the Misfit Toys. But I was always so afraid of the Abominable Snow Monster.
Who, Bumble? He wasn't scary. He was so cute.
Look, it's the scene with the elves making toys.
Hey, that head elf reminds me of someone from another movie.
Oh, never mind. He probably just has one of those familiar faces.
Oh, hi, I'm Buddy. Santa wanted me to spread some Christmas spirit, so here I am with some important advice. First, treat every day like Christmas. And remember, the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear. We elves try to stick to the four main food groups: candy, candy canes, candy corns, and syrup. And remember, there's room for everyone on the nice list. Now I have a question. Who's all on for elf practice?
Guys, it's been a cool night, but since we only have one controller...
I'm sorry, my little sister broke up the controller. She doesn't like to lose.
Maybe we could do something else.
A board game?
Nah.
Bless my head?
No, it's cold out there.
But what if it's supposed to snow?
Hey, that would be cool. We could build a fort.
Or have a snowball fight.
Snowboarding!
For now, no snow and it's almost midnight.
You better not wake up my sister.
Maybe we could... watch a movie.
What barrel is it?
We're not watching any more HGTV!
Okay.
Look, Home Alone. This one's a classic.
I want to see him. Kevin McAllister sitting in front of the bathroom mirror.
Hey, look, nothing's coming out. Just run out.
Thank you.
No, I just got something in my eye.
Here, we better keep these handy because the next thing we're going to watch, we're definitely going to need them.
It must be It's a Wonderful Life.
Now that's a good classic. Every time a bell rings,
an angel gets his wings.
I do love that one, but this one's more of a new classic, a Netflix classic.
It's called The Christmas Chronicles.
That's one of my favorites.
Mine too.
I haven't seen it yet,
but I can't wait. Where's the remote?
Let's look at the channel and see what else is on.
Oh no, if Kevin has a remote, we might be channel surfing for a while.
Next time. Well, see you soon, everyone.
I was hoping to find Christmas Vacation.
I just watched that last night. That movie never gets old.
I know it gets old.
What?
Us, while we wait for Kevin to find a movie.
This is a good one. Oh, Little Drummer Boy. This was my dad's favorite when he was a kid.
Let's check it out. Thank you.
movies are on.
Stop! It's the Grinch! Now, this is a true Christmas classic. We have to watch this one.
I'm going to need a few more cookies before we get started.
Wait, are you sure you don't want a three-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich with arsenic sauce?
I think I'm good with the Christmas cookies.
Who wants more hot chocolate?
Me!
Every Who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot. But the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. And please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. All their windows were dark, quiet snow filled the air. All the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. Then he came to the first little house on the square. This stop number one. The old Grinchy Claus hissed, and he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. And the Grinch grabbed the treat, and he started to shove when he heard a small sound like the coo of a dove. He turned around fast, and he saw a small who? Little Cindy Lou Who, with not more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny Who daughter, who got out of bed for a cup of cold water. She stared at the Grinch and said, "Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking a Christmas tree? Why?"
Snow,
so puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day.
Ready to hit the hay?
No! I have at least 4 more movies in me!
Alright, well, let's watch until the sun comes up.
Alright, let's do this!
Dang, I'm pretty excited to see the sun come up.
No, not that. I just saw the best movie ever. Oh, Polar Express! Now, this is the GMAT.
Wait, what?
GMAT! Greatest movie of all time!
I get it. Like, go, greatest of all time. I see how you did that.
Hey, get ready to board the train.
All aboard the Polar Express.
Ha ha, hey, we got it! Ha ha, hey, we got it! Ha ha, hey! so sweet. Well, the night's still young. Let's see what else is on.
I want to watch a Hallmark Christmas movie.
Are you sure those are Christmas classics?
It's just not the Christmas season without watching a Hallmark Christmas movie.
Well, they do all kind of have the same plot, and they do all turn out the same. A girl leaves the big city, goes to a small town to close down a small local business, and turns it into a big business.
She meets the grandson of the founder of the business. They decorate a Christmas tree together, drink hot cocoa, sing carols, and fall in love.
Ooh!
She decides to save the local business, and the town is saved.
Oh, wait, I think I saw that one.
You know, watching these movies tonight has been fun, but I don't know if any of them capture to the true meaning of Christmas.
Yeah, they have shown us that Christmas means spending time with friends and family, eating yummy treats, doing festive Christmas activities,
angels, and good deeds. But I still think there's something more to it.
Hey, look, now there's the true Christmas classic, Charlie Brown.
I guess you were right, Linus. I shouldn't have picked this little tree. Everything I do turns into a disaster. I guess I don't really know what Christmas is about. Isn't there anyone who understands what Christmas is all about?
Sure, I can tell you what Christmas is all about. And there they were, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them. And the glory of the Lord showed round about them. They were sore afraid, and the angel said unto them,
Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in the manger.
And with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, and praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
That's what Christmas is all about, Charlie Brown.
Born today, and then will it fall?
Thank you, everybody, for coming this evening. And I think everybody will agree, this performance was spectacular. Your kids were outstanding. And parents, we want to thank you because we know without you and without you choosing Catholic education, we don't have anything. So thank you for choosing Assumption. And, of course, a production like this doesn't go off without every classroom teacher and aide and assistant helping out. So if I could have all the classroom teachers and faculty stand up so we can give you a round of applause. And then there's a few people that we'd like to thank in particular. First of all, if Jen Bollinger could come up. Jen Bollinger is a behind-the-scenes girl that we don't know what we would do without. And she pretty much picks up the pieces that everybody drops and makes it come to life. She ran the sound. She ran the music. She ran the lights. She's just amazing. So we'd like to thank Jen Bollinger. Mrs. Carlson, if she could come forth. She also helped. And then Mrs. Pescarino, who is responsible for putting it all together. This was an incredible night. Thank you, everybody, for being here. God bless you, and have a Merry Christmas. If we could have our first grade parents, first graders, raise your hands. They're in the center aisle. So if our first grade parents would get your first graders, that would be wonderful. Second graders are on this side of church right here. Raise your hand. Oh, never mind. Oh, I'm sorry.